Have you ever seen somebody do something that so amazed you that it blew your mind? I've seen it a few times in my life. And one of those times in particular happened this last fall. It happened with my own dad. So you gotta know my dad. My dad went from being hunched over, walking with my mom's walker, to trekking in the Black Hills. But when I say you gotta know my dad, you gotta know that he's 80 years old, he's overweight, and he does not like to work out. In fact, one of his oldest jokes is, he's the before picture and I'm the after picture. So he definitely does not like to work out, and he had what seemed like a minor fall turn into something that ripped out a big part of his life. So it all happened one day when we were over at the house, and he bent over to pick something up and he fell. And the next day he was complaining about weakness in his legs. Me being in with a chiropractor, I realized that, you know, maybe he just threw something out of alignment. So I had him go up to see the chiropractor and I did some rehab with him. Nothing got better. Things in fact didn't get better so bad that my chiropractor ordered a MRI. Nothing came up, so we continued with rehab and chiropractic. He continued to get weaker. So we got another MRI ordered. Still nothing showed up. And he continued to get weaker and weaker. Now another thing about my dad is that he's a tough guy. Back in the day, he was a city champion wrestler in Minneapolis. He was also known for being quite the barroom brawler back in his younger, more sordid days. But this time he was scared. He was so scared, in fact, that he decided that he might have to sell his house, his pride and joy acreage lot where he could do all his projects. And he also updated his will, and he had a meeting with my brother and I. He was scared. For once in his life, he didn't know what was gonna happen. Finally, we got a third MRI, and we figured out what the problem was. He had a benign tumor in the middle of his back. The first two MRIs had missed. So, immediate surgery was required for this. And we got the tumor out, but afterwards, even though his feeling came back in his legs, he was very, very weak. And so he was weak, and he needed to get stronger. But right behind that surgery was deer hunting camp. Now, my dad has been hosting a deer hunting camp for almost 60 years. And this was gonna be the first time he wasn't gonna be able to hunt. And I know, even though he was at the cabin with the guys, when we walked out of that cabin to go in the woods and he couldn't go, it killed him. And I realized that when we got back, this was the tipping point for him, because every year my dad he likes to hunt, but there's two Super Bowls of hunting. Number one is the deer camp in the fall, which he just missed. And number two is coming up in the spring, which is spring turkey hunting in the Black Hills in South Dakota. And I know he did not want to miss that. And he told me he did not want to miss that. So he said, I need you to get me stronger so I do not miss that trip. So we began to train. And for once in his life, my dad had to listen to me. And he actually did above and beyond what I asked of him. He actually came in on his own and worked on the treadmill and did the endurance protocol that I put together, which I was really surprised that he did. But his drive was there. He was driven to get back what he had lost. I'm not gonna lie, there's a few times where he questioned me and said, is this really working? And he, you know, being my dad, do you really know what you're doing? You know how all the dad questions come out. But I told him to trust the process. And little by little, he started to notice the changes. Things like his balance improved, his strength increased, he had more endurance. And finally got to the point where he was confident enough to go back out and do some pheasant hunting, where he could walk the fields with one of his friends and start to test himself a little bit. So by the time that South Dakota trip rolled around, he was more than ready. In fact, out of all of us in the Black Hills, he was the first one to bag his turkey. And that was a big win for my dad. Another big win was when we came back, he was able to resume doing projects around the house, which right behind hunting is his number two, is doing his yard work. And so to this day, I'm proud of my dad, because he's continued to, not only that he worked so hard, and I saw him come so far in so little time, but the fact that he continues to do those things, because he realizes now that a little bit of physical maintenance goes a long way to keeping him enjoying the things that make his life whole. So my 80-year-old dad can do it, I think anybody can do that. If my 80-year-old dad can go from a walker to walking in the Black Hills in a matter of months, I think anybody can accomplish a fitness goal. Anything's possible. So out of this thing, I learned three important lessons that I think really come out of this. Number one is that with a strong purpose, you know, my dad's purpose, his passion was honey, and a vision, walking the Black Hills in South Dakota, anything's possible. And it's important that you have that well-defined and in front of you, and I would even encourage you to take it a step further and write it down and attach a memorable picture to it. Because we know life is distracting and you'll miss out on those things. If you don't have that in front of you, you'll lose vision and focus and you'll get off course. Number two, whenever you're facing a challenge that seems daunting or maybe next to impossible, you need to ask for help and hire someone. You're never gonna be able to do it on your own, and a good guide is gonna give you the plan to get there. You know, I told you my dad was really scared. He didn't know if he was gonna walk again, if he was gonna have to go into senior living or whatever, and that scares him because he's a fiercely independent guy. But the great thing is I have some neurology training, I have some advanced corrective exercise training, and I had the plan to get him there. Some of the stuff seemed weird, but it all was relevant to his goals. It was all relevant to restoring his nervous system back up so he had good balance, good coordination, good proprioception, so he could continue to hunt and not worry about falling and hurt himself. And then number three, any good goal is gonna require extra hard work, discipline, and persistence. And there's going to be setbacks. And you gotta know that you gotta stay the course. So my dad does not like I said, going to the gym, but he took time away from doing his other things. He's retired and he's got a lot of other hobbies. He gave some of those up to get his butt in the gym and do what he needed to do, even though being in the gym wasn't something that's his favorite. He disciplined himself to make standing appointments with me and with the treadmill, even coming in on Saturdays, which is like his big work day and go check outdoor gear day. He made that sacrifice so that he could get back to doing what was important to him. And so that's the thing with any big goal. No one's gonna hand it to you. You're gonna have to give something up to get something. So wherever you're at today, remember my dad's story that you can make great progress no matter what your age is, your physical shape, where you're coming. If all those things are in place, you can do awesome things in your life.